Hello and welcome to V Podcast. We have all heard the terms 3G and 4G and know what they stand for. But the terms as we understand them today are generally used in the context of computers and information technology. In today's V Podcast, Ms. Swarna Kail, Associate Professor and Head, Department of Mathematics, gives us an overview of the evolution of the educational system. Beginning with the Gurukula system of the ancient times, Ms. Swarna lists out the various milestones of progress and carries the talk down to the present day and age. While she expresses a feeling of loss at having to give up some of the pleasures of the education conduct prior to the pandemic, her podcast ends on a positive note, reaffirming the faith in the fact that the world will bounce back in full vigor. Let's find out what ma'am has to say about the different generations in the evolution of the teaching-learning process.
Nowadays, we are using the word 4G in all fields, in all aspects of life. But when the educational institutions closed during the last week of March 2020, we never thought that education also would become 4G in the next academic year. Yes, the new academic year is starting on 1st June 2020. And we are going to face a tremendous change in the education system this year. Before discussing the 4G education system, let us examine 1G, 2G and 3G systems of education. 1G is the Gurukula system practiced in ancient India. In this system, the students or Shishyas were living with Guru in Guru's house. The Guru-Shishya relationship was very sacred. The students learned from Guru and helped him in everyday life, including household chores. At the end of education, students offered Guru Dakshina either in the form of money or some special task the Guru wanted his student to accomplish. In this system, all the students from prince to poor child lived with Guru for years, disconnected from their family. 2G education system is education through schools, colleges and universities. The students and teachers go to educational institutions in the mornings and return home in the evenings. Teachers get training in teaching and teach the students according to a timetable and syllabus. It has a 10 plus 2 pattern now. Of course, we have LKG, UKG and pre-KG classes before first standard. In the 10 plus 2 pattern, the first 10 years are further subdivided into primary education and high school education. This is followed by 2 years of higher secondary course or junior college. We have public schools and private schools. A majority of students study in government schools for free until the age of 14. After plus two, students have to join college for 3 year graduation course, 2 year post-graduation course and then for higher studies like MPhil, PhD, etc. There is a slight change in professional colleges where graduation is 4 years. Here also, the teachers are given training in the form of orientation course and refresher course by the universities. Then 3G system. Here, we have options for continuing education through evening colleges, open education, distance education, certificate courses, UG and PG diploma courses, and so on. These courses are tailored for employed people. for improving their qualifications and also for obtaining promotions in their jobs. But here also there are compulsory contact classes on holidays where we have physical presence of a trained teacher. Of course, study materials are provided. 4G education system is online education system. In this system, students meet the teacher only through videos. Teaching, assignments, exam, publication of results, everything is done online. Doubts are cleared through chat boxes. Only the students having very good internet connection can enter into the live class. For other students, recorded videos will be sent and they can access it at their convenience. This system has both advantages and disadvantages. In the present situation, we are unable to go to schools and colleges due to COVID-19 pandemic. So, online system is a blessing. Also, students can save time without traveling and the time can be utilized for listening to recorded classes, doing assignments, reading e-books and attending webinars. The disadvantages are the teacher is not getting any formal training and so the classes may not be clear and audible. Teaching mathematics through online is going to be very difficult because to understand a method, problems ought to be worked out then and there. The students who are not having computers, phones or good connectivity are going to miss the classes. The teacher cannot categorize the students as average, above average and below average and teach accordingly. Since the audio and video of the participants are muted during the online session, the teacher does not even know whether the students are listening and getting the concepts taught or not. Also, the students and teachers are going to miss so many things. First, the campus. We cannot imagine a campus without students. In Kerala, Praveshanotsavam is celebrated in schools during the first week of June to welcome the new students to the first standard. The smell of new books, new bags, new umbrellas and new dresses are going to be missed. The crying of new child, the anxiety of parents, the love and care of teachers, the morning assembly, we are going to miss everything. Second, the friendship. Students are going to miss the company of their classmates and friends. Traveling in the bus, school van and autos together. The mischiefs, the guidance and mentoring of tutors, the canteen, NSS-NCC activities, camps, discussions about association activities, day celebrations, study tours, everything is going to be missed. Third, the advice. Teachers are not teaching only the subject. In between, they give lots of advice. They tell them their life experiences for overcoming difficulties. They want their children to be good, courageous with positive thinking, obedient and well-disciplined. Teachers are actually second parents. So, in the online teaching system, students are not going to obtain overall development. In spite of all this, as a teacher, I firmly believe that the current situation will change. We will overcome all the difficulties and the campus will once again flourish with students, their mischiefs, their naughtiness, their songs, their dances, their joy, their happiness, and of course, their victories.
Thank you, Swarna ma'am, for your enlightening podcast that brims with hope and optimism.